amigos, ¿cómo están? Yo soy Cara y me encuentro aquí en la Unboxing Toy Convention en el World Trade Center en la Ciudad de México y conmigo se encuentra un súper, súper, súper invitado que todos los fans de Star Wars seguramente conocen y me están envidiando mucho. Y es que conmigo se encuentra Keith Simmons, que, wow, es un gran, gran, gran fotógrafo de la serie de Star Wars, que es como muchos lo conocimos. Kim, ¿cómo estás?
Thank you. Hello. I'm fine, I'm great, thank you.
Bienvenido a México. Hay una historia que hemos escuchado acerca de negativos que rescató sobre las figuras de Star Wars. ¿Nos podría platicar un poco sobre eso?
I was looking for more tripods and more stands, and my boss, at the time, my boss goes, they're down in the basement, here's the key. So I go down the basement, the elevator opens, and I go into the step in, and it goes slosh, 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 and I'm going, oh, crap. And I turn on the light, believe it or not, pull the light, and one light bulb in the whole basement, and I find what I'm looking for, and I'm looking around, and I'm going, oh, my God, what's this? And I looked, pulled out a few of them, and there were two trash bags, trash cans about so big, filled with negatives and film, or, you know, transparencies. And I pulled them up, and I go, oh, this is Star Wars. Oh, this is Star Wars. Oh, crap, this is Star Wars. So I took my stuff up that I needed upstairs, and I said, I found a bunch of film down in the basement. It's all the early stuff and some other stuff from Star Wars and whatever. And I'd really like it if I could kind of get them and kind of preserve them. And my boss, Roy Frankenfield, said, well, you can do that, but you do it on your own time because I'm not paying you to do that. And pretty much that was the way it went. And I saved him out of the basement. This is way before digital. Today I would have saved every one of them. But I went through and there were some really damaged ones I'd kill to have right now. And I didn't. But I went through and saved the ones that were not damaged. The rest of them I did throw away. They were seriously damaged. And I just put all of them, made sure they're all in sleeves, and I saved them all. And the rest is history.
¿Y tendrá alguno de los negativos, bueno, de las fotografías que salvó aquí expuestas para que las podamos ver?
Yeah, there's a bunch of them in here. There's a bunch of them in here, yeah.
En un momento más.
Everything prior to probably, I'm guessing, 1980 and earlier. Yeah, all the ones that people freak out about. I mean, not all of the ones they freak out, but a good number of the ones they freak out about. Yeah, I'm dead serious.
¿Y hay alguna en particular que le haya gustado mucho rescatar o que sea como, wow, qué bueno que rescate esta porque me encanta?
I don't have a favorite of one of those. Come on, they're all great. I love them all.
También una duda. Usted vivió sobre la fotografía, el paso de la fotografía digital, cuando mucha gente no creía en esa. ¿Cómo fue arriesgarse y defender algo que era nuevo en una época donde no se arriesgaba por nada nuevo? ¿Cómo fue, que no sé qué tan difícil fue o qué se necesitó dentro de usted para poder dar ese paso?
I took a big risk, a huge risk, because nobody was taking it. Nobody wanted it. I had a different studio with another company that I was doing work with called Totes. And that art director was like me, kind of looked at the future and could see things. And then now I had something to show people. Then I started doing some other things with Kroger Company and I showed them what I could do with it. And they liked it. I did ice cream too. I shot ice cream. So when it came time, I was able to move forward. And I started shooting little things. I shot Cindy the doll for Kenner. I shot other little things to show Kenner that it would work, how it would work. And they were pressed. They liked the idea. So it took a long time before they would accept it, before they bought onto that idea that, oh, we can save money. And this will work. The turnaround, they liked it. The funny thing is, when I was told that, oh, Kim, you're going to be shooting E1, that's episode one. They said, you're going to be doing it digitally.
Whoa.
I said, okay, no problem. The separation house that was going to handle all the separations, on break, after they heard that, they said, you know what? We're going to have your lunch because you're going to fail miserably. The first image I did for them, it came back. They had a print there, which I gave them, with the figure and their separation print, proof print. And they say, see, it doesn't work. The art director at Hasbro at that point, looked at it, takes the figure, puts it next to it, to my print, and hit their print. Looked at it, and he goes, you know what? He looked at the bottom of the figure, he says, that's green. He says, you fix it. We're going with what Kim does. Honest to truth, that's what happened. I was exceedingly lucky at that point because I had been educating him the whole time. From the very first time I tried breaking him into digital, I was educating him on the color, on everything about it. So I was reprinting articles out from the internet. I was showing him everything, dropping him off, and I was educating the different art directors so they could see and use whatever I would come up with. So they weren't playing, somebody wasn't just coming and saying, here, it is. I literally was going in and saying, I want to educate you how to do this. And after I did Cindy, I did it film, digital, same image, filmed, no more cost to them, just back and forth. He liked what he saw, but he wasn't, that's okay. It's called a learning process. So as I educated them, so when it came time for the episode one image and he said yes, he was all primed, he was ready to go.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm dead serious. and I will tell you right now that for to go into digital at that time, I'm glad you're sitting down, because at that time you had to have literally a dedicated computer system just for the camera and by the time you finished with the camera, the computer system, and everything that went with it, you were looking in excess, just a little under $50,000. Something that you can now do that is a higher resolution, not as good as quality, yeah, as your iPhone. I mean that camera today, I mean, if I still had it, takes still beautiful shots. But unfortunately, the computers are so far ahead of it that there's no interface anymore. But it's actually a gorgeous, still beautiful camera. I still use the files. I still pull up the files and utilize them. So, yeah. It was a huge gamble.
Y ya por último, rapidísimo, ¿alguna anécdota rapidísima, buena o mala, que haya pasado profesionalmente hablando?
One of the funny ones, Harry Reisner, I did a catalog shot for Harry Reisner. It was for the Ewoks. It was the Ewok battle wagon. He came in on Friday morning, and he gave me his line drawing of what he wanted everything to look like, and the placement. He said, make the setup like it's indoor, and you take care of that. But he says, and here's the placement of how I want it to look. I said, okay, I can do that. And I'll be back at 5 o'clock that night. And that's when I will work on it. Okay. So I had it all set up. The Polaroids were all done. He could take that overlay, lay it right over the Polaroid. It matched perfectly. 5 o'clock. He comes in. He looks at it and he goes, oh, that's great. But let me try this. And we move for the next 6 hours. I'm dead serious. For the next 6 hours, we'd move a figure here or there, take a Polaroid, move a figure here and there, take a Polaroid. I mean, constantly. Finally, at 11 o'clock that night, Friday night, he says, that's it. you could take that overlay off of that last Polaroid and put it on the very first Polaroid, and they matched. I'm dead serious. Exactly the same. I mean, I loved Harry. Harry was a fan. I loved the guy. Was really great. He wanted his fingerprints on. He wanted to see what else would work. That's all it was about. What else would work? And it really came down to, we had it right the first time. That's a true story.
Muchísimas gracias a los dos también, a su maravillosa intérprete, sin lo cual esto hubiera sido bastante más complicado. Y bueno, muchísimas gracias. Gracias. Thank you. Thank you. Y bueno, seguimos aquí en la Unboxing Toy Convention. Yo soy Cara y no se despeguen, juego amigos.